Fox Luca è Sharper Trades e Mixed and Wall Street with the market make another all-time high. The SPY was up at 337.02 and then a pullback. It's near channel top, so we might see either a consolidation or a pullback. Let's see if this consolidation lasts a couple of days and then pops some more. And our next targets are 337.77 and 340.62. Or if it pulls back further, in that case, the primary support is as always the ATMA. Below that, this trend line, which comes near the 228. And obviously the channel bottom and the 50 simple moving average is a must hold support. If it breaks, then it breaks this long-term channel that's been in place since October. And then we'll have to adjust the position. But for now, we are still bullish, very strong market. There's some concern today, the Powell, the chairman of the Fed, spoke, and there was some concern in some of his comments, especially with regards to the virus that is affecting commerce, not just hotels and cruise ships and travel things, but the way products are made, the factories, employers, and the shipping, all that stuff has been affected in China, and it could have an effect in the next 2 or 3 months in the rest of the world. So he called for some cautions moving forward. There's you know, still very bullish outlook for the market, but you know, one day at a time, the trend is your friend, and right now is bullish. And let's see if in the next couple of months or weeks changes the sentiment. For now, stay long, all is green. And let's take a look at the individual stocks that we are following, starting with Abio. And this was a day trade yesterday. I'm just showing you this because of the action that we got today. Volume is good, steady, OBV is pointing up. Today extended as high as 338. And the target for this one, the next target is 361 and channel top. This is a falling channel, so this is not in an uptrend and it's just made a base. But anyway, it could run up here to the 200 simple moving average. Any pullback, the ATMA is the line in the sand. AVVM, this was a day trade yesterday that worked very well and then rolled over. And today open lower down at the 50 simple the moving average, and look at this reversal candle. So yesterday was in the indecision. Big, when you have longer legs, that's a bigger indecision, especially with the upper shadow being longer. Yeah, there was more selling pressure, which brought price down at the opening at the 50 simple the moving average. But immediately the low and the open were almost exactly the same, 1120 and 1118. And right away started to move up, as you can see here in the 1 minute chart. Big rally immediately, and retested the first resistance at 1283 and the second resistance at 1422, which was our target yesterday. And this is a major reversal candle, most likely will extend to 1561, that's our next target and channel top. And if it blows through with the kind of energy got today, we could see in the next few weeks, 17, 1880 and 2050. The support, primary support is 1250. Secondary support is the ATMA at 1116. AMD, this was a day trade that worked nicely. Not a lot of percent, 3%, but you know, 3-4%. But you know, everything counts, everything is good. So let's see, let's go inside the, okay, there it is. Okay, inside the 1 minute chart, oh, there we go. So we got the nice rising channel, popped immediately, big volume, consolidated, and right here when it was 54.50, I said, take your profit, most likely this is done, and it was done. Popped, pullback, pressed, pullback, pressed, pullback, triple top. If the third or fourth is unable to do it, it's gonna go lower, and he did. We tested the VWP. which held it for some time, struggled with a little bit at reverse, and then rolled over, and then closed below the VWAP. This one, as a day trade, was fine. Long term, this is a very bullish chart. Now we have a resistance near 55. Next targets, if it extends, 57, 90, and 60, 98. This company makes chips, and not potatoes, but microchips. And Apple yesterday announced that they might be using their microchips instead of Intel. So that's a very bullish news for AMD. And Intel wasn't really as affected. So let's see how much truth of it comes out. But yesterday, action was very bullish as a result of the news. And today, extension reiterates the confidence. And this is an all-time high breakout. By the way, there we go. Okay, anyway. So that's where we are with the AMD. And AMKR, this was a day trade that worked nicely for just a few minutes. Not my favorite ones when they do that, but you know, again, you take what you have. The pre-market was rather quiet with this good consolidation above 13.15. So if you enter, even if you enter in the pre-market, that's your line in the sand. And immediately it popped open to the upside and started to rally, reach the first target, 14.24, and then extend the size 14.82. Pull back to cut the VWP. Usually when it moves that fast, that's bound to happen, which is never a good sign. So this one was already struggling in my mind at that point. Pull back to the 50 simple moving average, held, try to reverse. And then when it presses, it needs to pop the VWP and pull back, retest it, and hold. In this case, pull back, struggled, rolled over, retested the primary support, the secondary support actually, which was 1380 for us. And didn't do anything. So it just moved sideways, try, but you see the VWP is the resistance. Here, tried again, but they made a lower high with regards to those prior highs near the 14 level, and failed and closed down where it started basically. So this, again, it worked just briefly in the morning and that's it. It's holding the support, big volume. So let's see if this one consolidates and does a reversal, in which case we could see 1520, 1615, 1787, the support of 13, and below that the 12. But again, that's it for us. Anyway, I'm showing you this because this chart is moving sideways, is not dropping, that's a good sign. But most importantly, because an analyst today covered this company and gave a target of 5. So it's in the gold. Gold will move if the market gets a big panic. And right now the gold is moving sideways. Let's see. GLD. And there, sideways. So not going much. But if something happens in the market or this coronavirus, hopefully won't. But if it does get out of control or causes something unexpected, it's more like the unexpected things that sends market spinning, then we could see gold running. So AOI is still in our list. Move sideways again, it's not doing much, but keep an eye on it because again, our targets are 431 and 488, but this analyst gave a target of 5. And the volume is nice and steady. Oops, Billy, this one was a day trade here, so keep an eye on it. A few days ago, popped big time, reached two targets, 24.26, consolidated for a couple of days, and today popped some more near the channel top. If you're trading this one, it's a good idea to take some profit, but it's possible that with this kind of volume, it could blow through the top of this channel. And who knows, we might even see 30, 29.95, 28.14 and 29.95. Above that, 32.72. Anyway, if you're trading it, those are your targets. The support, 80 May, 24.47, that's it. DDD, it's making a consolidation. The technicals are very bullish down here. Price is still struggling though. The channel bottom and 11 is holding. That's all I want to see. Any move below that, out. Channel bottom is holding. And we need to see a retest of this 1215 resistance. If it blows through it, 1315, 1447. And who knows? Let's see if I can grab this line. Yes. Maybe even 1579. Doku is extending. Today made a high at, what the heck is going on up there? 85.98. Channel top is near 87. So if and when it gets to channel top, take your profit. Don't play game with this one because it rallied nicely. It's been up almost every day since January 27. Take your profit. Now we are tightening the stops all along. I don't have the list in front of my eyes right now, but write this down. So your primary support is now 84. Secondary support is 81. Those are both tight, but you know, we got to secure our profit because these things will reverse. As soon as it pulls back, it could make a big move. And retest the channel bottom, which is what usually happens. DQQ, this was another day trade, it worked nicely. Didn't do much per se, but pull back, test the 50 simple, the moving average, rally to the resistance trend line, pull back again to 64, consolidate, and then into the close, it went up again, 67. All over the place, not my favorite day trades, but again, nice 8% on the day, but for us, much smaller. I think it was 3% or something like that. Let's see. Yeah, 3-4%, not much. But anyway, the bullish, the technicals are very bullish. 69 and 74 if he extends. Any pullback, careful. There is a big gap here, which we'll try to fill it if he rolls over. So the support, 64. And today's low, 60-80. Intel, pressing is 67.50. For resistance, it's a stubborn one, but let's see if it blow, if it breaks it, it's a mid channel above that, looking for a resistance of the channel top, and then this high is 69, 24, 29, above that 70, 50, and 73, 74. Remember, this one has been up significantly for us since the breakout here, and then the explosion to the upside, following positive earnings. That was fortunate. And now it's in consolidation. So let's see if this consolidation lasts another couple of days or if it's ready to pop or it rolls over. Always three scenarios. We'll see. Time will tell. Now, this is my favorite day trade. JKS. This is the day trade you want to be in it when it happens. That pops, pull back, held the support nicely, and move steady inside the rising channel like this one did. And let's take a closer look at the one in the chart was okay. Pre-market was rather quiet with support at 22. And then as soon as he opened, started to move big volume, 150,000 through the shares right at the opening, big rally, green, red, green. When you have a green, red, green, up, down, up, that's usually very bullish, especially holding some support, the open, the close, and the open. Very bullish, popped again, rallied some more. Our target was 23.82, first target. It was shy a few pennies of it, pulled back, retested the VWP, held it nicely. Look at this. Big pop on volume, pull back, retest on low volume. Consolidation, and then reached the target, 23.82. And then extended. And I said, trade the channel. Near 25, I said, take your profit. Because of this drop on big volume, oftentimes, that's an indication, you know, this is done, especially lunchtime, and is up from 22 to 25. That's 12%. Take your profit. And this one, if you held onto it, no, we always tighten the stops. So you can choose to take the profit, peel some off, or remain in the trade. Consolidated nicely, nice and steady. Look at the VWP. which was our secondary support, hello, held all along, and then a massive volume again, the same, 120,000, something like that, and in the green, and made the price rallied some more. In fact, reached our target, 25.89. Look at that. 25.67. There was no 87. 25.87. Where is it? There it is. 25.87. 2 pennies shy of it. Powerful. Anyway, this with this kind of volume closing at the high end of the session, it doesn't look done. There's a channel top. Let's take a closer look. Channel top near probably 27, 26.80, 26.70. All right, that's the channel top. And then above that, next target, 28.09, 30.65, 33.10. Powerful. Primary support, 24. When you have a big candle like that, half candle. And any move below that, that's it. This one moves fast, so see what it does. If he pulls back and retests this 23.80, that's actually and holds. That's a good re-entry opportunity, I'll say. But again, it's near channel top, so be careful because this consolidation could last some more and rolls over into the 22 and the 50. Possibility. Anyway, today's action is very bullish. Solar, as I mentioned before, is a trending sector right now. 10, see, big pop. So, good looking chart. Light reached the target today. This is our, let's see, second target, 88.11, first one, 92.71, the second. Now this one, to the penny, I believe, 92.75, power. And pullback. Now with this one, we are also tightening the stop. This is up since the alert, which came on this breakout David volume. near 84, 8-10%, anywhere in between that. Nice move. And an extension, I'm looking for 97, third target out. Any pullback, the primary support, 89, that's super tight. Secondary support is this day low at 85, 76, so let's call it 86. Max. Popped and reached near the target. 1977 was the target. 1945 was the high. At that point, when he was testing this high, I said there is a resistance, 1950. Consider taking some profits, peel some off. This is the second target. When he reaches the first target, stay in. Reaches the second target or near the second target, take some off. A third, half, or all. Technicals are bullish, most likely will extend. Our next target and last one is 21.44. Let's see if and when he gets there, what it does. This one is one of those that moves rather fast, so we'll see what kind of action he gets moving forward. The primary support, it's, let's see, 18.70, I believe. So we 18.40. Let's see, those set of eyes right there. And this eye, 1940, primary support. Secondary support, 1730, 1740, somewhere in this area, below the 18. And Vita, popped some more, strong resistance here at 2457. It's testing it today, the high was 2535. Next target, this is already reached our third target, so consider taking some profit or close the position. If he extends, this might be getting exhausted now. If he extends, 26.52 and 28.75. If he pulls back, the 80 May, 22 needs to hold. Any move below that, it retests the 200 down at 20.57. That's many points from now. From where it is today, down to the 200 simple moving average, that's 18%. Don't give the money back to the market. This thing could go to 50, but it could also go to 19. Protect your capital, protect your profits, time the stops. When something moved up this much, remember, this has been consolidation. This was an alert through here. to hear popped on huge volume. And so even if you didn't enter prior to the market, prior to the pop, you enter during the pop, right in this level. So where it is today, 15%. Don't give it back. Cash it in. SDC pressing this resistance target at 1487, that's our target. Very strong bullish chart. I need more volume to confirm the breakout, to push through the breakout, which is the high right there, 1487. Targets, 1637, 1778, and 1953. The earnings are coming up in a few weeks, February 25th. So we still have a couple of weeks for this one to start working. Generally, I don't like to hold position through earnings. Sometimes I do, like I did for pins, because I had the feeling that it would work, pins, and it worked out very well. Right through here, I closed my position here at 27 in the after hour market when the market popped, when they popped, falling positive earnings. So that was 22% overnight, you know, in just a few hours. So anyway, sometimes I do hold position over earnings, but generally I don't. SDC looks very bullish. I wanna see the move before the earnings, because the earnings is a binary event. It can go either way, so it's more risky, right? So, but that's, you are the trader. You choose the path and the way you like to trade. You have to know your limitations. You have to know your strength. You have to know your risk tolerance. And position size is a big piece in it. So that's all up to your comfort zone. This one, again, I want to see a pop before. So before the earnings approach, we can close the position and be happy with a good maybe 15, 20, or even 30%. So that 1750, 58, which is my third target, that's what I'm looking at. But ultimately, I think if this thing start working nicely, we could see 21 channel top. That's my fifth target, especially with the way this chart looks, very bullish. So we'll see. But right now it's right at this resistance and needs to break it and hold before it does anything. The primary support, 14 and 13. Space, another day trade that worked, okay, not that bad actually. A decent action above the 2109 and made a high at 2228. Very bullish chart. This one as a swing, we are not trading as a swing, but if you are 23, 25 channel top, any pullback, the ATMA, that's 19, 20. TNDM popped and pullback retest, mirroring the market. So if the market weakens, this one could also weaken. There is support, it's currently holding, but I need to see a better, improved technicals. I don't want to see the OBV come back below the moving average. I don't want to see price return inside this consolidation, because the idea for this message, for this alert, was the breakout. And it's currently holding the high, 77.52, 78.75. So we're right there, a few pennies below that. So this is still considered a breakout. But in its volume to confirm, we are not getting that. So let's see if this consolidation moves sideways, breaks to the upside, or pulls back. If it pulls back, 50, the ATMA, primary support needs to hold, secondary support is 73. And extension, 82 and 91. And finally, work. Work after the fantastic day yesterday, and then a reversal in the after hour market, following the disappointing news that the IBM was already using this system before the news yesterday. But market reversed. The 24.28 held, our 25 primary support also held. So both support, primary and secondary are holding nicely and is now up against this resistance target of 26. Look for a break and hold above that. We're looking for a retest near 28.09. That's our secondary support target. Above that, 30. Any pullback, remember, primary support 25, secondary support 24.20. All right, folks, thanks for watching and good trading. See you tomorrow.